I don't know if my water will be warm enough to thaw it and wash it all away. And would you look at that? Hey friends, it's Ranger Jason here at the Ligon Lodge. It's a little bit cold, so we've set up in front of the fireplace here down at the cabin at the lake. I'm gonna show you how to make some casts with plaster using molds that we have here at Ligon. If you can't go out in the woods and find any, we're gonna go through how to set up your molds, mix your plaster, make some casts, both for indoors and outdoors, go over some safety tips for you, and just get outside and see what we can discover out there today. So stay tuned. So when you're mixing your plaster up and you're cleaning up from it, there's a few things that you want to take into consideration. One is how you're going to mix it. If you're going outside and going into the field, I find that having pre-mixed bags is more convenient. You put your amount into each bag, and according to this, it's again 3 scoops of the mix to 1 scoop of water, or 3 parts to 1. I usually mix up enough material to do 2 casts in 1 bag. You get more than that, it starts getting too much to handle. If you are mixing a lot for several people to do casts, like if you're doing this for a classroom and you're gonna use an item like a pitcher, you can put your plaster mix in here and add your water and use like a paint stirring stick or even just a stick out in the woods. Get that all stirred up really well. Do not rinse any of your plaster mix down a sink drain. I've seen people make that mistake and you will plug up your drain. We're gonna go ahead and pour some casts. I'm gonna show you the difference between this cast and paint mix compared to the plaster. We're gonna just go ahead and pour in some casts right here. I have a turkey print, a deer print, and a goose print. Instead of unzipping this and pouring this out to the side, I like to just make a little cut in the corner of the bag and squeeze it out, kind of like a pastry chef would do with some icing. Just to cut a corner off of that bag to make a hole in it. And then you can start squeezing your plaster out right into your print. And we'll use a ruler to press it down in with to flatten it out. Make sure we don't have any space, air holes in there. And what we do is we let it sit for a little bit, and every once in a while we'll tap it, and that will let air bubbles come up out of that plaster mix. I'll just tap it now. Can even start to see air bubbles starting to rise up out of there. While that's setting up and drying, I'll show you one that I did yesterday, okay? I poured this yesterday, and it took about 45 minutes for it to set up. And it pulls right out of that. This is an antelope, a young antelope, pronghorn antelope print. Looks like a deer print, very similar, but this is a pronghorn. How do you make a cast outside? That's a good question. And all you need is a cereal box or some kind of box. I used an old Girl Scout cookie box and just cut some pieces out of it. So all you gotta do is, you know, bend it around and either tape it or staple it real quick to hold it in place. Whichever way, okay. So this would be way too much excess, but you can still use it. Just pour in maybe 1 inch worth of plaster. As long as your mold is covered where the print is, that's all you need. So inside I showed you how to mix up your plaster and how to make molds. If you have a pre-made mold, how to pour it. If you're gonna go outside in the woods and you find some prints down in the mud, how to make a cast ring. Yesterday afternoon I made one and set it here just like this and poured it full of plaster. The dirt around it is frozen hard, so I'm just gonna pour some warm water on here, soften the ground up a little bit. We're gonna pop this out. There we go. And see about washing some of this dirt off. I don't know if my water will be warm enough to thaw it and wash it all away. And would you look at that? That is a squirrel print right there. So thanks for joining us on Lessons from Ligon. This is Ranger Jason. Hope to see you out here at Ligon real soon. Yeah.